guys, so welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know the last time I posted was about 3 weeks ago, so that's almost a month. Things have been a little crazy, a little hectic the past month that I've been training for this competition. I'm officially 8 weeks out, so I'm excited. I'm a little nervous. I don't know what to expect. My body is still changing. So during my first month of prep, I actually moved and I moved into my own apartment. And now I am 10 minutes away from my job, my new job that I have been working since the beginning of the year, which I'm still trying to progress and learn new skills while, you know, preparing for this competition. So a lot of things have changed and a lot of crazy happenings. So I actually moved during the seminar that I really wanted to go to. It was like a so do you want to compete, somewhere in that realm. Well, I was planning to go to that seminar so I can learn more about, you know, what to expect in my first bikini competition, but you know, things happened, so I had to move during the weekend, and that was really tough, guys, because my workouts are a lot longer now, and during that time I had a lot of cardio I had to do, and now my cardio is increased now because I am 2 months away, and now I'm trying to really shred and cut, especially in my stomach area. That's more of my stubborn parts that, you know, a lot of my fat goes into either my middle section and sometimes my legs, but you know what? I'm gonna work hard for it. I'm going to try to bring my best package in. I'm gonna do the best I can do. You know, every single day is a new workout and I need to push myself. So I did write a little list of like what I'm gonna go over in this video, and the way prep is going now, it's actually getting a lot harder since I'm closer to my show, and I really can't believe I'm, you know, 8 weeks out. That's, I don't know, that's, you know, 2 months, and a lot of things happen in 2 months, and 2 months can fly by real quick. So I do have some cardio in the morning time. My carbs have dropped. I do miss my food now. This is really hard, actually, because, you know, I do have a morning job, I do have a weekend job, so I try to juggle all my workouts in. I'm trying to practice consistency. My food is taken away. I really miss my carbs. Bulking, you know, that was hard for me because I had eaten so much food, and now, you know, my food has gone down, but I'm not starving. I always say that, I only say that when I'm in a really bad mood or I'm really hungry after a workout, but I still have a really high protein diet, so it does, you know, keep me full, but I do miss the bigger portions that I have. It's more of a, you know, high protein, low carb diet I'm on. One thing that's not taken away from me is oatmeal. I love oatmeal. You can do so many things with oatmeal. If you follow me on Instagram, I've been having this obsession with, you know, making oatmeal pancake where you can put egg whites, protein powder, cinnamon, almond milk, and mix it all up. It makes like a really fluffy pancake. And you can use sugar-free syrup, and it's like a healthy alternative of making a pancake instead of using those, you know, those batters that are more higher in calorie, not much nutrients in those pancakes. But mine, they are, if you want to add cheese seeds, that's awesome as well. It does help give the pancake a fuller taste to it. One thing this prep has really, really taught me now is really mentally challenging myself. You know, a lot of things have hit me left to right during this prep. And, you know, I'm trying to be as consistent as I can with everything I do. So I usually try to meal prep on Sundays, or if I have to on Mondays, because I do work Sunday nights sometimes when I'm waitressing. I get home late, but things have to be done, and I try to remind myself, you know, April 28th, whenever I'm tempted, I'm thinking about April 28th. Because it is really hard, guys. I work at a restaurant around, like, really, you know, really good food at my restaurant. And that I crave. I haven't had a burger since January. I haven't had a cheat meal since January. I haven't drank since January. But what really is keeping me going is my mental state, and also how I'm going to be on stage. I'm competing against myself and other people. I want to be the best I can be. Even though this is my first show, I want to put in all the work I can, you know? Bodybuilding is hard, it's expensive, and you're putting a lot of your time in it. And the time that I invest in it, I want to make sure I'm doing my all, my best. You know, there's days that I'm really tired, I really don't want to do the cardio that I'm supposed to do. You know, sometimes I'm on the Stairmaster, and how I get along with it, I just think to myself, this is gonna benefit me. This workout that I'm doing right now, you know, it's gonna benefit me in a couple weeks. I'm gonna start seeing more results. If I'm doing what my coach tells me and doing everything the correct way, I will get the results that I want, you know, in order to place. I do want to place on my first show, but, you know, can't expect much for your first show because it is your first show, but I want to bring my best for my first show. Another thing I did put in this list I want to talk about this video is there's days that are not going to be easy, and there's days that I'm just like, oh my gosh, I want to give up, but I have to tell myself to not give up because, you know, sometimes I'm so tired and drained from working two jobs and trying to compete and also moving, trying to settle in my apartment. That's a lot to handle all the 1 month, you know. I moved all 1 month while starting my first bikini show and doing the first month of prepping, cutting down all my food, doing more reps, lower weights. So what keeps me going is honestly thinking about my past. You know, my past has really pushed me to become the person I am today. And it does sound cliche, but it's true. Whatever experience you are going through right now, you know, it could be losing your job, going through a breakup, you're depressed. It could be anything that you're going through that is going to make you stronger for the future. Whatever you're feeling, the lows that you have is temporary. It's not going to be there forever. And what you do have the control to change it. So if there's days that you feel like you want to give up and you feel like the whole world's against you, you got to change that attitude and think about, you know, how you're going to fix it and how you're going to change it, because you are in control of your life. You are in control of your goals. And so whatever you do and whatever work you put in, it's the results that you get. So if I'm not, you know, meal prepping the right way, if I'm not eating my meals right, I'm not gonna look good on stage. You know, nutrition is key to how I'm gonna look on stage, okay? And I feel like, you know, whatever I went through last year and this year has really prepared me for this year to become a better person. I feel like I'm progressing to become a better me, and I'm starting to love myself a lot more, you know? And not where it's like a self-obsession thing, where I'm saying where when you start loving yourself more, you start loving people around you more. You know, you have a more positive outlook on life, you know, and the things that hit you in life, you don't take it where you put yourself in the corner. For me, you know, anything that hits me that it's gonna stop me from progressing, I wanna fight back that resistance. You know, an example would be if you live in Northern Virginia, we had a terrible storm, like a windstorm. My power went out. The day that power went out, I was supposed to do my cardio. And I prepared all my meals for the weekend. And I was like, oh my gosh, I do not want my food to go bad because I cooked all these meals for the weekend because I'm working this weekend. So what I did is I packed all my meals, put in a lunchbox, asked a friend if I could stay at their place in case my power doesn't go back on. Took my lunchbox to work, packed all my gym clothes so I can make sure that I can fit my workout in, because I'm not going to miss a workout. I'm going to try not to. If I do, I will make that up. So Friday was my cardio day. I put my cardio day with my leg day. So whenever you feel down, just keep pushing, you know. Don't give up, because when you look back, whatever you went through, and if you did keep on going, start looking ahead, you know, you won't regret what you did. You'll be proud of yourself. You know, there's days and times I'm not always upbeat, but then I have to remind myself. And a lot of my one of my best friends, I'm sorry for the ramble, reminded me to practice gratitude. Once you practice gratitude, you'll start to be more thankful what you have. You know, I'm very blessed to be able to finally move in my own apartment, be 10 minutes away from work, have supporters around me. And for me, in order for me to keep my sanity, I pray every day that I'm thankful for what I have in life and the people I have and the people that I let go in my life. You know, I'm really thankful and blessed to see how much I've grown, and it's because, you know, I do believe in a higher power, I believe in God, and I feel like He's watching me, and things happen for a reason. And, you know, for you all that are watching me, you know, maybe you guys have a different way of practicing gratitude. It could be meditating, it could be, you know, going for a walk. You know, do things for yourself that makes you feel better, that makes you become a better person. Because once you start loving yourself and you start to respect yourself more, you will set higher standards for yourself. And also, you will affect other people around you positively. And that's what I want to do. I want to affect people positively and inspire them to become healthy, fit, and to also pursue their goals. You know, I never thought I would be competing this year, you know. I was gonna wait and, you know, try to build more muscle, but you know what? When's the right time for anything? Nothing. This me moving, I didn't plan to move this early. I was planning to move after my show, but I found that perfect opportunity to move in with a great price with the area I live in, and I'm 10 minutes away from work, 5 minutes away from my gym, 5 minutes away from the grocery store, walking distance to all the bars, well, not bars, but food places as well. When I'm off the competition, I'm definitely gonna walk to all the restaurants to try all the food because I'm craving so many things. I probably will make another video of what I do to handle my cravings and how I cook my food, but I just wanted to update you all, if you are watching my YouTube channel, if you are following me, of how my prep is going. It is going really hard for me, and I'm trying to fit everything in my schedule and trying to stay sane. And for me to stay sane is to remind myself I have 2 months of this left, and I have 2 months to kick ass. Anyways, I'm gonna show you a few clips of my videos of working out. I don't think I would do like a particular like back leg day. You'll see like little things I've done throughout the whole month and how my posing is. I do have to practice posing, so you will see a clip of me posing. Other than that, I really hope you enjoy this video. I really hope I didn't ramble too much on. If you have any comments or questions below, comment below at me. If you have any comments or questions, please comment below. I will respond to them. And please follow me on Instagram. Alright guys, thanks. Bye.